Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. For many years, people thought that the sun went around the earth. We still use words like sunrise and sunset, which make it sound like the sun is rising and setting around the earth. Now we know that the sun does not go around the earth, but instead that the earth rotates on its axis, which is why we get night and day. We'll demonstrate how much sunlight someone experiences by using this model of the earth and a lamp to represent the sun. This view is from the North Pole looking south, so we can see both dolls at the same time. As the earth rotates, the doll with the red hat sees a sunrise, and a few hours later it's noon, so the daylight is very bright. Then the sunlight becomes less, and that doll experiences evening. Then it will get darker until it is midnight for the doll with the red hat, and a few hours later it will be morning again. At the same time, the doll without hat has exactly the opposite experiences, since its days and nights are opposite to the doll with the red hat. Just like people used to think that the sun went around the earth, people used to think that all of the stars also went around the earth every day. When this merry-go-round rotates slowly, this lady can barely feel or hear it moving, so she could get a feeling as though the sun and trees are moving around her. Since the earth rotates slowly and without making any noise, people didn't feel or hear any movements, so they incorrectly assumed that the earth was still and that the sun and stars were moving around the earth. This photo was taken by astronauts on the moon. In the last 60 years, we have taken lots of photos and videos from far above the earth that show us that the earth is round, that the sun does not go around the earth, and that the earth makes one whole rotation every 24 hours. Depending on where the sun is in the sky, shadows have different lengths. When the sun is directly overhead, such as around noon, shadows are short. When the sun's position is near the horizon, shadows are longer. Using our model, we can see the length of the doll's shadow changes throughout the day. The shadow is shortest around noon but longest in the early morning and late evening. Because the sun's position in the sky changes throughout the day, people use to tell time by looking at shadows moving during the day. This device is called a sundial. It works by having the shadow move next to numbers on the clock as the earth rotates. Here's a summary of this section. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. Our model may look wrong because the dolls are standing on what appears to be the sides of the earth. But this model is correct. For example, if we could see people walking in Europe, Central Africa, and South Africa at the same time from far away, we would see something like this. It might look like some people are walking upside down, but they're not. All the shoes are touching the ground. The word down refers to the direction that points to the middle of the earth, which is the bright yellow core in this animation. Gravity does not pull things to the north, south, east, or west. Instead, gravity pulls things down, which is towards the center of the earth. We just learned that no stars go around the earth, so what do you think is the explanation for the white streaks in the sky that we commonly called shooting stars? These are not stars. Instead, the bright streaks are made when space rocks burn in our atmosphere. Space rocks that are equal to or greater than 1 meter are called asteroids. As a reminder, a meter is about 3 feet. Space rocks less than 1 meter wide are called meteoroids. When meteoroids enter our atmosphere, which is the blue rim of air around the planet, we call them meteors. Meteors get very hot when they hit our atmosphere, which causes them to burn, and many turn into a harmless gas. The few space rocks that do make it all the way to the Earth are called meteorites. Like this one, meteorites often contain iron, so magnets attract them. In contrast to the Earth, the Moon has no atmosphere. That's why many space rocks can hit the Moon's surface to make craters. Some of those craters are so big, we can even see them from Earth. Here's a summary of this section. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. In contrast to the Sun, stars, and other planets, the Moon does go around the Earth. Astronomers use the word orbit instead of using the phrase goes around. Why do you think that the Moon orbits the Earth instead of the Earth orbiting the Moon? A major reason why the Moon orbits the Earth is because the Moon is smaller than the Earth. The Moon's diameter is less than the distance between the coasts of the continental U.S. The Earth's diameter is 4 times the Moon's diameter. That means the Moon's diameter is only 1/4 of what the Earth's diameter is. So the Moon's mass, which we can think of as being similar to its weight, is much less than the Earth's mass. In astronomy, objects with lower mass orbit objects with higher mass. The Earth's gravity is the force that keeps the Moon orbiting the Earth. In this image, we've made the size of the Earth, the Moon, and the distance between them all to the same scale. The Moon is more than 238,000 miles from the Earth. That's how far an average American drives during 20 years. In order to see enough detail of the Earth and Moon, this animation shows the Moon much closer to the Earth than would be correct. It takes the Moon almost 1 month to orbit the Earth. The word for Moon comes from the word meaning 1 month. In this animation, you can see the Earth rotating many times, because each rotation equals 1 day, and there are almost 30 Earth rotations in the same time that it takes the Moon to orbit the Earth just once. Although the Moon orbits the Earth, it does this slowly. So when we see the Moon appear to move across the entire sky in one night, that speed is due to the Earth's rotation. Unlike the Sun and stars, planets and moons do not make any natural light. What we call moonlight is really sunlight that has reflected off the Moon and goes into our eyes. This is similar to how light from our headlights reflects off a road at night, then goes into our eyes, so we can see things that are normally dark. Just like for the Earth, only half of the Moon gets sunlight at any given moment. The side of the Moon that is facing the Sun is bright, but the side facing away from the Sun is dark. When sunlight reflects off the Moon, we call that moonlight. Depending on where the Moon is in its orbit around the Earth, we see a full Moon, parts of the Moon, or none of the Moon. We call these different amounts of moonlight the phases of the Moon. The reason we can see the Moon when it is behind the Earth is because for a lot of the time, the Moon is slightly above or below the level of the Earth. So sunlight can reach the Moon, then reflects off the Moon's surface and comes into our eyes. When the Moon is behind the Earth, some of the Sun's rays reflect off the Moon and go towards the Earth, so we see a full Moon. At various parts of its orbit around the Earth, the Moon reflects different amounts of light towards the Earth, which accounts for the appearance of the different phases of the Moon that we can see. The Moon is shaped like a ball, which scientists describe using the math word sphere. Even though it might look like some of the Moon is missing during some phases, all of the Moon is there. The part we don't see is the side that is facing away from the Sun, so it's dark. Except when astronauts are visiting, there is no life on the Moon. One of the reasons there is no life on the Moon is because there is no atmosphere, so there is no air to support plants and animals. In this video taken during the daytime, you can see that the sky is black on the Moon. The reason our sky is blue during the daytime is because when sunlight hits the air in our atmosphere, the light scatters in a way that makes blue light the most common color. At night, our skies are black because there is no sunlight hitting the air. In contrast, on the Moon, the sky is black all the time because there is no air to scatter the sunlight. These spacesuits have oxygen tanks, so the astronauts can breathe air while they are on the Moon. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.